sunset is the most exhilarating wave because it offers a big variety. You can, you know, take off on the peak and get a huge, great drop. And I imagine it to be something like skiing, where you're skiing down a hill and you've got all the power behind you. You can force a big bottom turn, and then, you know, you can manoeuvre through the inside, and it's not just a quick little ride. It's a big drop and a big manoeuvre on the inside, a big tube possibly. It offers a lot, and it's got a big old warp in the middle of the wall sometimes, in the middle of the face because of the backwash, and it, and so much power. It's so intense, and the crowd makes it intense too. People want to get the waves, the biggest wave that comes through, and people want to get the best tube that comes through. It's just an amazing atmosphere out there. When you get sunset with no wind, and it's a clean 12-foot swell, 10 to 12-foot swell, the wave is totally manoeuvrable. You can muck around with the face of the wave. You can ride the wave for some distance, and the whole ride varies a bit. It's not short and sweet. You can feel the whole wave for some time. And it's just the thrill of being way out in the ocean too. It's an incredible feeling, you know, just being able to get one of those big beasts, even if it sort of flattens out halfway through.
The difference between Hawaii and the East Coast is like night and day. The East Coast is generally small and quite a lot less powerful, and coming to Hawaii is just an extreme change. You've got to get used to bigger boards, bigger waves, and a lot more speed. So, you know, for me, it takes a good couple of weeks to get used to the surf and the boards and just generally get in tune.
I've been a professional for about 6 years. Been on the ASP tour for 5 of those years. I've been in the top 10 twice, 9th twice, and 12th once, and I really look forward to bigger surf and events, and that's why Hawaii is one of my favorite places. And you know, I'm over here for a couple of months out of the year, and I just want to get the best waves I can, and the bigger ones are usually the best waves.
Well, cold night to you. Even
gets quite a bit more competitive. There's a larger number of guys on the circuit, a larger number of traveling professionals, full-time professionals, and it just gets more competitive and more difficult, and you've really got to stay keen. With my weight and size, small waves become a slight disadvantage, even though I've grown up surfing small waves and even won contests in small waves. I just think that now I'm way more comfortable in the big waves, and you know, I feel comfortable against anyone in any size surf when it gets overhead.
Well, Haleiwa is a pretty special place. It's one of the few places in the world that handles a really big swell. Right now it's very big. It's top of really starting to pitch, it's starting to get really scary. A lot of the tourists, even the good surfers, international surfers, find it a little bit difficult. They top of really testing. The local guys just get in there and rip it up. I was really concentrating on survival maneuvers today. Getting to the beach.
Development as a surfer, I really followed pretty much what could be called just the classic lines. I went to amateur surfing, I did my full routine there. I did the pro-am contests, you know, pretty successful. And then I stepped into pro surfing when I was about 20 years old, headed off onto the pro tour for 4 years, which was great fun. But I drew most of my influence from powerful surfers. Seem to be impressed by people who generate speed. by tilting their surfboards and using the strength and the wave's contour and the tilt of the surfboard and be able to generate a real lot of speed and make it look fairly easy. I really enjoy surfing any waves between 4 and 12 feet. That's my optimum size. 12 feet plus, I still enjoy it, but it's a different, you know, it's like, okay, take it in, you know, put into perspective, take care, watch out, make sure you don't do anything silly. And under 4 feet is like, it just gets a little bit boring.
I love Hawaii, so I always wanted to come here. So I heard the waves were really powerful and big and things, and the whole island's got, it's not just the waves, the whole atmosphere of the place is pretty good. I love it. My attitude is to not just surfing, everything's like, I like to have a go and I'll almost try anything once. And if it's good, I'll go back for more. My goal was to become a pilot. Like, to do the pilot's course is a year course, and it costs like 20 grand. And to do this professional surfing, it's like the first year is like a course too. It's almost the same price. So I won the New South Wales title, and I was really pleased about that because it's the most difficult state in Australia to get through. And in the nationals I got fourth, and then we went to the world titles, and I got third there, and that was my last amateur result.
It's really different. Like,
Hawaiian waves are much more powerful, they're more abrupt, they break a lot faster.
There's so many variables. You could snap your board on the first wave of a heat or get caught inside for the first 20 minutes of a heat, and it makes it really hard to come back. But if you have a heat where you're in really good rhythm, that's a really good feeling.
I was a New South Wales junior champion, Australian junior champion and world junior champion in 1982. That was my best year.
You never expected to be in the wildest dreams. So take a step backwards for a little while and find it there. Oh,
22 at the moment, and I'd like to keep progressing and this year maybe make the top 10. My best placing to date on the pro circuit's been some semi-final berths, a lot of fifths, multiple ninths. I like waves in the 6 to 8 foot range, tubes, lips. Rocky Point's a really good wave. Like the other day was the best I've ever had Rocky Rights. It was really clean, smooth, it was wedging. You could get in some really good manoeuvres. The wave that would best suit me, which I like to surf the most in out of everywhere, is a really good Hully Eva in the 8 foot range. That's my favourite wave. Smooth, clean, perfect Hully Eva. That's me. I love it.
Being a goofy foot, of course the left suit me fine. I like to surf waves like Jocko's and Pipeline and Rocky Point, but I also like to surf backside, you know, the rights at Sunset and Hully Eva. It's also challenging.
My dad was a lifeguard and he surfed, and when I was a young kid, he just kind of got me into it because we've lived at the beach all our lives. And I just kept surfing and surfing, you know, one thing led to the next. I got into competition and then I surfed in 2 world titles. I came second in the juniors in 84 and second in the men's in 86. So I, you know, I felt I was ready to turn pro at that time.
Soil's the gun.
Yeah, a lot of people think I surf like an Australian. You know, I take that as a compliment since most of the world champs have been Australians, but you know, I don't really dwell on it. I just surf, I go out there and have fun, and whatever my style is, that's how it comes off to everyone. So, you know, I do take that as a compliment, people saying I surf like an Australian. Probably, my main influence is probably Tom Carroll. I really like the way he surfs because of his powerful approach as well as radical surfing. He's always looking for the big maneuvers, you know, big, powerful snaps, and that's what wins him contests.
Competition has definitely disciplined me to improve my surfing and made me ambitious in that sense. I, you know, most definitely wouldn't be the surfer I am today without, you know, that competitive atmosphere. Carrying the crown can be taken different ways. For me, it made me so satisfied deep down, the fact that I'd actually pulled off both two world titles like that. But that can be dangerous, and that's something that sort of worried me at first when I lost the titles, that I was too satisfied to a certain extent. And, you know, I had to sort of get down, sort of ask myself a few questions about that, but I took it in a light that I was just really happy to have it and I wanted to hold on to it, but I couldn't fool myself about it. I think every surfer's got a responsibility to surfing as far as if we want to improve the image of surfing and if we want to improve our sport and, you know, make headway and improve the technology within the sport as well. I think a helmet's going to be useful in, you know, crowded big wave situations like Sunset and Waimea. I figure that I'm pretty accident prone, so I want to break down the chances of any really serious head injury, which is something I'm pretty sort of afraid of, because I knew I had to go for it for the competition. Be conscious. I mean, we're talking about professional surfers here. We've got to take a professional attitude and carry it as much as possible, but don't by all means lose our identity.